C++ IO library header files. So in this session, we are going to discuss what are the required header files we are supposed to include in our C++ programs and what are the necessary functionalities will be obtained from them. So first one, we are going to discuss IO stream, that is input output stream. The file defines the cin, cout, cerr and clog objects which correspond to the standard input, that is cin stands for standard input, we are going for standard output, that is our cout, the unbuffered standard error stream, that is cerr, and the buffered standard error stream, that clog. So these are the objects are defined under this IO stream header file. If you go for this IO MANIP, this particular header file's name, the file declares the services useful for performing formatted IO with so-called parameterized stream manipulators such as setw and setprecision. So in our coding, if we require some formatting, let us suppose I want to print one age of a person with 8 spaces are there, the width will be, the column width will be 8 columns. So in that case, we will be using this setw. So w stands for width. Say in case of set precision, how many digits we require after the decimal point, if I want to judge that one, if I want to make that one fixed, so to have the formatted outputs, we'll be including this header file. Next one is fstream, that is a header file name, and this file declares services for user controlled file processing. We'll discuss regarding this one in the other file IO chapter. So these are the main three header files which you include for this IO processing. Thanks for watching this video.